Beryl, Beryl, Beryl is my school. Best education reservoir for young learners just like me. Beryl,
good morning, my dear school students, and welcome once again to Beryl Learning. Today we'll be looking at a topic on the board, applications of Pythagoras rule to real life problems. Now, last week and I think 2 weeks ago, we talked about Pythagoras theory, where we said that for a right angle triangle, the square on the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square on the two remaining sides. That's the Pythagoras rule. We went further to look at Pythagorean triples. Pythagorean triples, where we say that for Pythagorean triples, we have three sets of whole numbers that obey Pythagoras rule. We say for Pythagorean triples, we have three sets of whole numbers that obey Pythagoras rule. Now we have these numbers on the 3, 4, and 5. Let's assume we have a right angle triangle of size 3 and 4. 3, 4, and 5. Now, these three sets of numbers obey Pythagoras rule because the square of 3 plus the square of 4 is 3 square, we have 9. Plus 4 squared 16, that's equal to 25. Now the square root of 25 is 5, so we have 5 squared. That's 3 squared plus 4 squared is equal to 5 squared. 3 squared is 9, 4 squared is 16, and 5 squared is 25. 9 plus 16 is 25, that means 3 squared plus 4 squared is 5 squared. So what that means is that this set of numbers obey Pythagoras theorem. They obey Pythagoras rule. It therefore means that they are called Pythagorean triples. 3, 4, 5 are called Pythagorean triples. There are other numbers that obey these laws. Now, we also have numbers like 8, 15, and 17. Any set of whole numbers that obey Pythagoras theorem is called Pythagorean triples. Any three sets of numbers like this that obey Pythagoras theorem is referred to as Pythagorean triples. Now, today we have this, a ladder 22.5 cm long leans against a vertical wall. The ladder is 7.5 meters away from the wall. How far up the wall does the ladder reach? Now, we have to apply this in solving. Before we do that, we first make a sketch. We have said that the ladder is 22.5 cm long and it leans against a vertical wall. So, we sketch the ladder. We say it's 22.5 meters in length and it leans against a vertical wall. We have our wall. This is our wall and this is our ladder. It leans against a vertical wall and the ladder is 7.5 meters away from the wall. That is 7.5 meters. That means from the wall to the ladder, we have 7.5 meters. From the wall to the ladder, we have 7.5 meters. Now, how far up the wall does the ladder reach? See the wall? How far up the wall does the ladder reach? We call this point X. We have to find X because this is the point. When we say how far up the wall does the ladder reach, we're referring to this part of the shape we have. Now, if you look at the board, this shape is a perfect example of a right angle triangle. The perfect example of a right angle triangle. And as such, we apply our Pythagoras theorem. Remember that the Pythagoras theorem is only applicable to a right angle triangle. We say the square on the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square on the two remaining sides. And on this, on what we have on the board, the hypotenuse is this. The ladder forms the hypotenuse of 22.5 meters. So the square of the hypotenuse 22.5 is equal to the sum of the square of this and this. So applying Pythagoras theorem, say applying Pythagoras theorem, the square of the hypotenuse, that's 22.5 meters squared is equal to 7.5 squared plus x squared. Remember what we said, the square on the side of the tennis is called the sum of the square of the two other sides. That's 22.5 squared is equal to 7.5 squared plus x squared. Now, the square of 22.5 squared gives us 506.25. If you multiply this by itself, you get 506.25, and 7.5 squared 56.25 plus x squared. So we square this, meaning this times itself, 22.5 times 22.5 gives us 506.25, while 7.5 squared is 56.25. At this point, we collect like terms. X squared will now give us 506.25 meters squared minus 56.25 meters squared. That's this minus this. We subtract that, we get 450 meters squared. Our x squared is now 450 meters squared. So our x will be square root of 450 meters squared. The square root of this will give us 21.2 meters. 21.2 meters in one decimal place. We have 21.2 meters. Let's take it again. You see, a ladder 22.5 meters long leans against a vertical wall. The ladder is 7.5 meters away from the wall. How far up the wall does the ladder reach? And I said before we do that, we make a sketch. The ladder is 22.5 meters and it leans against the vertical wall. It's the vertical wall and the ladder leans against the wall. And we are told that the distance from the ladder and the foot of the wall is 7.5 meters. The distance from the ladder and the foot of the wall is 7.5 meters. Now, how far up the wall does the ladder reach? Now, at this point, how far up the wall is the ladder reach? Because we find the unknown S. And we say that this forms a right angle triangle. And for a right angle triangle, we apply Pythagoras theorem. When we say that the square on the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square on the two remaining sides. Meaning the square of this side is equal to the sum of the square of these two sides. And so we say 22.5 squared is equal to 7.5 squared plus x squared. That is, this square is equal to this square plus this square. At this point, we square this. 22.5 times 22.5 gives us 506.25 meters squared. And 7.5 times itself gives us 56.25 meters squared. So this is equal to this plus x squared. At this point, we collect like terms. X squared will now give us 506.25 minus 56.25. We subtract that, we have that our x squared is 450 meters squared. But we are looking for x and not x squared. So this x squared is 450. Our S now give us square root of 450 meters squared. We find the square root of this, now that X to be 21.2 meters by approximation. So the length of the wall is 21.2 meters. Now let's look at this question. The chord of a circle is 15 centimeters long. It is 6.3 cm from the center of the circle. Calculate the radius of the circle to the nearest whole number. Before we attempt this question, we first draw the circle. So we make a sketch of the circle. Now, we are told that the corner of the circle is 15 cm long. We have our center of the circle, O. And we have a chord. Remember we said about a chord, this is our chord. We are told that it is 15 cm long. So here is 15 cm. This is our center, O. Now, it is 6.3 cm from the center of the circle. That means from this point, from the center to this point, we have 6.3 cm. Let us calculate the radius of the circle to the nearest whole number. See the radius. We say that the radius of the circle is the straight line that starts from the center of the circle to a part of the circumference. So this is a radius, and this is also a radius. They're all radius because they start from the center of the circle to a part of the circumference of the circle. Now we have to find the radius. Our chord starts from here to here, but this figure has two right angle triangles. Since we have 15 cm here as our length of chord, this point is half of 15, that's 7.5. We have 7.5 here and 7.5 here. So, since we have a right angle triangle here, we now apply Pythagoras rule. I said the length of our chord is 15 cm, meaning this point has 7.5 and 7.5. So, we apply Pythagoras rule. Say, apply Pythagoras rule. We have R squared is equal to 6.3 plus 7.5 squared. Now, our R now represents our hypotenuse in the right angle triangle. We have the right angle triangle. Our R now represents our hypotenuse because it's the longest side and it also opposite our angle 90 degrees. So our R is our hypotenuse. So we say R squared is equal to 6.3 squared plus 7.5 squared. You see the length of our chord is 15 cm and half of it gives you half of 15, which is 7.5. So we have R squared equals 6.3 squared plus 7.5 squared. So 6.3 squared gives us 39.69 and our 7.5 squared gives us 56.25. That means our R squared will give us, we add this together, that's 39.69 plus 56.25. Now we have 14, 7 plus 2, we have 9, we have 15, 4 plus 5, we have 9. So that gives us 95.94. We have 95.94. That means our R will give us square root of 95.94. R now gives us square root of 95.94. That's about 9 points. So 9.79 cm. Let's go over it again. We say a chord of a circle is 15 cm long. It is 6.3 cm from the center of the circle. Calculate the radius of the circle to the nearest whole number. And we begin by making our sketch. We have our circle with our chord. With our chord of 15 cm. We are told that it is 6.3 cm from the center of the circle. And from this point, the center, to where we have our chord is 6.3 cm. And since we have this, the length of our chord is 15 cm. Half of it is 7.5. That means this point, the base of our right angle triangle is 7.5. So we have 7.5 and here 7.5. We can see that we have a right angle triangle, or rather two right angle triangles here. Two right angle triangles that are the same because we have our height of 6.3 cm and their bases of 7.5 cm each. So since it's a right angle triangle, we apply Pythagoras rule. You see that Pythagoras will state that the square of the hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square on the two remaining sides of the triangle. Always for a right angle triangle. So we have our hypotenuse to be our radius, which is R. So you see, R square will now give us 6.3 square plus 7.5 square. As we have here, R square is 6.3 square plus 7.5 square. The square of 6.3 gives us 39.69. And the square of 7.5 gives us 56.25. So we add them. So R square is now equal to 95.94. Since our R square is this, that means our R is square root of 95.94. And we have 9.79 cm. So our radius is 9.79 CM. We have to calculate to the nearest whole number. To the nearest whole number. So our radius give us 10 cm. That's to the nearest whole number. So our radius to the nearest whole number is 10 cm. Okay, we'll stop there for today. I'll just give you an assignment which we'll do and submit as soon as possible. Okay, the chord of a circle is 18 cm long. It is 6.3 cm from the center of the circle. Calculate the radius of the circle to the nearest whole number. Number two, the sides of a rhombus are each 4.2 cm. The longer diagonal is 7.4 cm. Find its shorter diagonal to the nearest whole number. The first question is similar to the one I solved previously. Just apply the same thing, just the same principle, apply the same principle and you get the correct answer. With this, we have come to the end of the class for today. Please, for JSS2 class, I have not been seeing your assignments. Most of you have not submitted your previous assignments, so I want to encourage you to do your assignment and submit as soon as you can. It will be marked and corrections will be made and it will be returned to you. See you next week. Keep on being good students and staying safe at home. Goodbye.